Hey, space explorers, Caroline here. Did you know that scientists have been searching for life in our solar system since the 1960s? At first, it was thought that Mars showed promise, but NASA's probed missions to the planet didn't find anything. Soon, scientists began expanding their search. What do you think emerged as the most likely place in the solar system capable of supporting life outside of Earth? Moons. Our solar system has nearly 300 moons, and while many are similar to our moon, rocky, dry, and lifeless, others may actually have what it takes for life to emerge and survive. Today, we'll look at three different moons in our solar system. Each of these moons is thought to have the necessary ingredients for harboring life. What do you think that list includes? Pause the video for a moment and make a prediction. It's commonly assumed that liquid water is a requirement for life. However, it's possible that another liquid solvent could take the place of water, such as methane or ethane. The moon would also need a source of energy, such as sunlight or thermal energy, stored under the surface. And life as we know it is based on organic or carbon-based molecules. So finding examples of these molecules, or at least the building blocks of them, would be promising. Other requirements would include protection from harmful elements, such as extreme temperatures, radiation, and meteorite impacts. Today, we'll take a look at the moons Europa, Titan, and Enceladus. As we do, keep the requirements for habitability in mind, and see if you agree with scientists' prediction that these moons could potentially harbor life. If not now, maybe sometime in the future. You may remember that Galileo spotted four moons orbiting Jupiter with his rudimentary telescope in the 1600s. He used this observation as further proof of the heliocentric model of the solar system. Those moons were Io, Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto. One of them, Europa, just might have the right conditions for life. At first glance, it might not look like much. Just a smooth, icy world with long cracks across its surface. But hidden beneath this thick layer of ice is an enormous ocean, twice the amount of water found on Earth. And we know that liquid water is one of the key ingredients for life. So, how do we know there's an ocean down there? In the 1990s, NASA's Galileo spacecraft flew by Europa and detected a magnetic field that matched what we'd expect from a salty global ocean. Then, in 2018, scientists re-examined Galileo's old data and realized that the probe actually flew through plumes of water erupting into space, meaning Europa might be releasing ocean water through cracks in the ice. If we could fly through those plumes again and sample them, could we possibly find hints of life? NASA's upcoming Europa Clipper mission is set to do just that. Could something be swimming in Europa's dark ocean? We don't know yet, but that's why we explore. Does Europa also check the other boxes for habitability? First, it likely has an energy source. Scientists think hydrothermal vents might exist on its seafloor, just like the ones on Earth that support deep-sea ecosystems. These vents provide heat and chemicals that microbes could use for energy. Second, Europa may contain organic molecules, the building blocks of life, either delivered by comets or formed in its ocean. Finally, its thick ice shell acts as a natural shield, protecting anything below from harmful radiation, extreme cold, and asteroid impacts. This means that if life ever started in Europa's ocean, it could have survived for billions of years, waiting for us to find it. So it's a definite possibility. But it may not be the only one. Let's see what secrets some of the other moons in our solar system hold. Our first stop in Saturn's neighborhood is the moon Enceladus. If Europa had a little water spewing out, Enceladus is a fire hose! This tiny moon is covered in ice, but near its south pole, massive geysers blast water vapor, ice particles, and organic molecules into space. The first hints of this came from NASA's Cassini spacecraft in the early 2000s. It detected complex organic molecules similar to the ones that form amino acids on Earth. Just like Europa, scientists think there is an underground ocean on Enceladus that may have hydrothermal vents that produce heat, making life possible. Other than being much smaller, Enceladus is very similar to Europa, so learning more about either one would help us understand the other better as well. But Enceladus isn't the only moon around Saturn that could potentially support life. The giant ringed planet also hosts the moon Titan. It's the only moon in the solar system with a thick atmosphere, and if you stood here, you'd feel like you were in an orange haze. Its atmosphere is made of nitrogen and methane, which gives the entire moon a hazy appearance. Titan has a thick atmosphere primarily because it is thought to have trapped large amounts of gas-rich ice within its interior during formation, which was then released over time. But what's really cool? Its surface is surprisingly Earth-like. Titan has lakes and rivers, except they're filled with liquid methane and ethane, not water. It's so cold here, minus 290 degrees Fahrenheit, that water is completely frozen. But methane takes its place in a fully functional weather cycle, similar to the cycle driven by water on Earth. It even rains. So, could life exist here? What do you think? Pause the video for a moment and record your thoughts in your notes. Remember those requirements for life we listed earlier? Well, we know life on Earth needs liquid water, but what if life could use liquid methane instead? If so, Titan could be home to totally alien organisms, completely different from anything we know. The Cassini-Huygens mission gave us our best look at Titan yet, even sending a lander, the Huygens probe, to its surface in 2005. And in the 2030s, NASA hopes to fly the Dragonfly drone across Titan's surface, searching for complex molecules and chemical reactions that might hint at life. While Europa, Enceladus, and Titan get a lot of attention for being moons that may be capable of supporting life, they're certainly not the only interesting moons in our solar system. Elsewhere, among our planetary neighbors, we find moons with volcanoes such as Io, one of Jupiter's other Galilean moons. We've also found the potato-shaped moons named Phobos and Deimos that orbit Mars. Uranus's moon, Miranda, has a terrifyingly tall cliff, and Neptune's moon, Triton, is one of the most geologically active moons in the solar system, likely originating from the Kuiper Belt. And speaking of the Kuiper Belt, did you know that even dwarf planets can have moons? Pluto has 5 moons, and its biggest moon, Charon, is so large that some astronomers consider Pluto and Charon to be a double dwarf planet system. In your lesson activities, you'll take a closer look at several of these moons to understand just how much variety can be found right here in our own solar system. And who knows? More moons could be discovered any day. Maybe even more that could support life. As humans look to continue exploring the solar system in generations to come, moons will likely be the new frontier to focus on. Well, that's it for today, Moon Hunters. As always, never stop exploring and marveling at the wonders of the universe. See you next time!